Lucky ducky, Nathan's in a mood to just keep making things.
Quack, quack.
Quack, quack. He's got some plans. He really wants to make this like Angela Lansbury ode to Murder, She Wrote nail. So we've just had a little creative powwow session. I think we've figured out what we're doing. And Nathan's going to create this. We're just going to make one and we'll work on. I'm going to let you do this and I'm going to step you through it.
Jessica Lansbury.
Yeah?
Here we go.
She's your like, is she your girl crush right now?
She's always been my girl crush.
You're like an old soul. Are you like 187 and you just didn't tell me?
I wish.
I think you might be. Okay, so we got to paint that one white.
That is correct.
That is correct. I think maybe, do you want me to paint it? Just like do her fast? Get her done? Or do you
want
to do it?
If you want to, you can do it because then it makes this more of a team thing.
Yeah? Team effort? Okay. Before I do that, I'm going to just take this little edge off. See these little things right here? Drives me nuts. So I just like to smooth it out, get a nice sharp tip on the edge of that. It'd be very dramatic with this beautiful stiletto tip.
Put some
sound
effects to that.
These tips. You want to be my sound effect? You're my color guy? Thank you. Thank you very much. These tips are great. They're from Clear Jelly, Clear Jelly Stamper. And I use them all the time when I'm doing demos. They're fantastic. They just snap onto these little things. Would you not say they're very user-friendly for the first-time user, Nathan?
They're extremely user-friendly.
Right. Okay. So I am just going to do one thin coat. How's your freehand skills, Nathan?
Sharp.
Yeah?
Like a razor.
My freehand skills are grade A certified shit. Yep, not afraid to admit that on my YouTube channel.
I have a steady hand, and I've actually been complimented on people on how steady of a hand I have.
Ooh.
Mm.
Okay, well, you're drawing the lines.
Excellent.
So Nathan's idea, this is really like mostly your plan here. I mean, I gave you a few suggestions, but this was really his idea, is to create a nail that looks like a piece of paper with blood smatter on it.
Splatter.
Smatter? Splatter?
Splatter.
Whatever. I like smatter. Okay. So I think we can definitely do one coat.
Yes.
White paints. We're going to cure this for 2 minutes. And then we're gonna see your...
This?
Not yet. We're going to put the lines on.
Okay.
Okay. Into the light. Okay. Red 102. We're going to add a little glitter because Nathan feels it's appropriate. It's like the first thing you ask for when you go in this room. Glitter!
Ethan!
Okay, so.
Please, everyone.
Just feast your eyes.
As I take you back to high school. To your...
Foolscap.
Red lined paper.
Make sure they're straight.
Do the margins.
Are you going to do them... Oh, you're legit doing, like, the thing.
The margins.
Oh, wow. Maybe just one margin. Like, creatively, I would say do, like, one margin. Like, it's a segment of that piece of the paper, kind of, you know?
So then I don't know if I should go this way, and then I'll do, like, lines along.
If it were me, you know what I would do? I would do my margin right along sort of, like, there. And then...
I'm not going to do that.
Okay.
Just because you suggested
that. This is our relationship, people.
Just because you suggested that.
This is your creative design plan. So you do whatever makes your heart happy, my friend. Okay. I like your music selection for this.
Hummy!
Are you stumped?
Nope.
Are you sure?
I'm just going to get my lines right.
Okay, you probably gonna out freehand me here. Do you know what some of the educators who are really talented with paints recommend? When you get lines you like, cure it. Flash cure it.
Yeah.
Because if you screw up a line after having, like, say, 7 perfect lines, but you didn't cure in between, then you have to wipe everything off. This is just my limited knowledge.
Trouble.
Like that.
So I should cure before I move on, you think?
If you are happy with your current lines, yep. You do have a very steady hand.
Thank you.
Impressed. You know what I would do? Can I tell you what I would do?
What?
Because this looks really perfect right here. But this looks kind of messed up down here.
Mm.
I would just wipe off that bottom part very carefully. If you want, I can do it for you.
Sure.
Cure your perfect lines and then go back and redo those three.
Okay.
Yeah?
Sure.
Okay. Let me help you.
Because
you did really good.
Nice of you.
And that's hard to do. Mm. And I don't want to see that get messed up.
No, I don't want to see it get messed up.
Now, if I screw it up, I'm going to feel like an ass.
Don't you ruin this for me.
I'm not going to ruin it for you, Nathan. I'm not going to ruin you. So perfect.
My career lies on this moment.
Okay.
Okay.
We got rid of the funky lines, but I would cure that.
You know?
Oh, are you kind of liking the way it looks right now?
Yeah, because now it's like that top margin of a paper. Because you know when it's blank?
Yeah. So you could literally write something in there.
This is like a header, almost.
Like the start of a book.
I'm actually going to roll with it like that.
Ooh, this is how nail techs work, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You're more of a nail tech than you
Somehow
even realize.
I'm going to cure this because I want to keep that.
Yes.
Correct?
You are. Uh-huh. Into the light.
1 minute?
1 minute.
Somebody, somebody. Somebody, somebody, babe.
The technique of the smoke idea that we were using. Nathan, you have a plan for this?
I do have a plan for this.
Okay, tell the people your plan.
So I want to simulate as if Jessica Lansbury is writing on her paper, and as she's typing, we'll say some said blood drips come down and hit the paper in certain spots.
Okay.
But what I'm going to try and do is just lightly smoke them out to the point that it's almost like it's dissolved into the paper.
And then are you going to add some more prominent blood drops on top of that?
Mm-hmm.
Or, okay, cool. All right. Well, have at her.
Oh, I'll have at her.
You're very good at this smoke technique now. This is
going to
become like your singing.
I love
that it's like
storming
thundery
out.
Yeah. Storming out, and we're creating this like eerie blood drop nails. So if you're going to smoke these out, all you got to do is basically put a few dots in the area where you want to smoke it out. Don't use a lot. And then take your alcohol and mess it up. But you just want to drop a few little drops here and there. But you don't need a lot.
Nope.
Like, you don't probably even need as much as you've got there. Like, just take what's on your brush and just lightly dab around. Yeah. Exactly. You got it. Okay. I'd probably stop there and melt that out a little bit.
Okay.
Somebody, somebody. Somebody, somebody, babe. Somebody,
Nathan, and you want to create sort of like definitive just blood drops now, right? A little bit of blood smatter.
Correct.
So I was suggesting to Nathan that maybe you'd want it a little bit darker. So the great thing about paints is that you can mix and blend to create what you want. So I think what I would do is take a little bit of red and mix a little bit of black in just to give it that really almost dried blood look. So go ahead, and you're gonna need a lot more than that, my friend.
Oh.
Wipe it on your thing a little bit more. Yeah, right. Like pick up another thing and kind of roll it off your brush. Yeah, there you go. Now wipe that off so you don't get red in the black.
Correct.
And
don't
pick up
to ruin the paints.
Pick up about half that amount of black, because black is really, really dark. And just blend it out a little bit. Here, I'll move that for you.
That's too much black.
Okay, so if it's too much black, you can go back into the red, pull a little bit out, and customize your color.
Excellent. So now I'd want it to look nice.
There you go.
Kind of dark, vibrant red, if I can.
I'd say that's pretty close.
Just a nice kind of cherry color.
Okay, you happy with that?
I'm happy with that.
Okay. So now what you want to do, you know what, I'm going to help you with one thing, because you want to be able to pick that up really nicely. So I'm actually going to take this little spatula, and I want you to dip the tip of your brush right into that red. There you go. Here's your thing. I'll hold this for you.
Okay.
And drop your blood smatter where you want it. I would recommend a few little tiny specks in and around where you've sort of created that blood smatter. Yeah.
I want to be more at the end of my brush here.
Yes, you do. Look at it, you're learning so fast.
Okay.
Okay. Is that what you want?
That's what I want.
Okay, let's put it in the light. Time to cure it.
Okay.
Can we just talk about the creepy thunder? I really hope everyone can hear this. It's like the perfect, Mother Nature knew we needed this like sound effect today.
Who done it?
Who done it? You did it. It's definitely you.
Colonel Mustard.
In the kitchen.
In the dining room with the candlestick.
Okay, Nathan, what are you calling this nail? Tell the people what you just told me you were calling this nail.
I would like to call this nail the Murdoch Mysteries CSI Murder, She Wrote Sherlock Holmes.
You guys missed the wild gesturing that was just happening across from me. I wish you could have seen it. Yeah, it was like, it's epic. It's a pretty cool design, and I'm not gonna lie, when you first suggested this, I was like, okay, see how this goes, but buddy.
I know, it's a bit more Dexter-esque.
It's cool.
Right now,
I
yes.
like it. I feel like I want to
this is called
take
the
this nail and build a set around it that you made the first one.
Ooh,
can
that's
I do
like
that?
The rest of the page?
Yeah, the rest of the story.
Do two more nails out here that is just paper, and then
or
one
maybe
just has
we
like
should
some
just,
blood right here.
Should we just say this? Do you want to come back and we'll do another one one day, and we'll just build on our story?
Yeah.
Okay, I think that's what we should do.
Or we can just call this
episode
one
two.
Dry air.
This is episode one. Stay tuned for episode two, people. Okay, so we're going to post a few reveal shots, and there's definitely going to be more to this story, I feel.
I like it.
Thanks for hanging out with me. You did a great job.
Thank you very much.
Are you proud?
I tried my best. I think that looks pretty cool.
I agree.
I think you're going to be starting a whole line of these nails now.
I think you're totally right.
Mystery nails.
Let us know your thoughts in the comments, people. We definitely want to know. And I will link all of Nathan's social media in the description box so you guys can go and give him a follow. Okay. Till episode two. Stay tuned to be continued. Bye.